Ever wondered why some Asian populations have a unique eye shape? Well, science has a pretty cool explanation for that. What many people notice is actually a feature called the epicanthic fold. And guess what? It's not exclusive to Asians. This trait is commonly found in East Asian populations, but also appears in certain indigenous groups in the Americas. Now get ready for some fascinating facts, because the story behind this involves cold weather, evolution, and even ancient sunglasses. The epicanthic fold is simply a small layer of skin that partially covers the inner corner of the eye. It's super common among Chinese, Japanese, Koreans, Mongolians, and Southeast Asians, like Vietnamese and Thais. But it doesn't stop there. You can also find this feature in Inuit people from Canada and even some indigenous groups in South America. And here's another fun fact. Babies from any ethnicity can be born with this fold, though it often fades as the nose develops. So, why did this trait evolve? The most widely accepted explanation is that it helps protect against intense light and extreme cold. In icy regions where there's a lot of snow and ice, sunlight can be blinding due to its strong reflection, causing what's known as snow blindness, a condition that damages the cornea. The epicanthic fold reduces the amount of light entering the eyes, acting as a natural defense mechanism. Pretty smart, right? If the environment presents a challenge, nature always finds a way to adapt. Want proof? Just take a look at indigenous Arctic peoples who developed primitive sunglasses with small horizontal slits. The logic behind these early sunglasses is the same. Limit the amount of light reaching the eyes to prevent damage from ice glare. Another interesting factor is fat accumulation around the eyes, which can act as natural insulation. Since fat retains heat, this small layer could help stabilize body temperature, an incredible advantage for surviving harsh winters in places like Siberia and East Asia. And here's one more fascinating detail. A 2015 study suggests that frequent squinting in response to environmental factors, like extreme cold, dust, and UV light, may have led to the hypertrophy of the orbicularis muscle over generations. In other words, the constant need to protect the eyes from harsh conditions might have played a role in shaping this physical trait through evolution. Hey everyone, hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you learned something cool and new today. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel so you never miss awesome content like this. Oh, and make sure to ring that bell so you're always in the loop. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.